When running on Kubernetes, we constantly have pods spinning up and spinning down according to the amount of traffic that our website receives, or maybe when we deploy a new version to production. And in order to cope with that, we have to configure a proper SIG term handler in order to gracefully shut down our workload. But what if I told you that in many cases it is not enough and your load balancer can still send traffic to a pod that is already terminated? So in this video, we go over the processes in order to cope with those situations, and I'll introduce you to a lifecycle pre-stop hook. So how does a SIG term work? Our process receives a SIG term from our operating system and the Kubernetes in order to start a graceful shutdown process. And in this process, it might tell the ingress controller to deregister it from receiving additional traffic and finish processing all of the tasks that it has before terminating. This is a great process for you to implement in your application. But there might be a race condition in this situation where your application, the pod, will ask the ingress controller to stop sending traffic, but it will finish draining all of the connections that it has and will terminate before the ingress controller has finished the deregistration process. And in this case, we will continue to send traffic to a terminated pod, which will go to nowhere, and our users will receive error codes. But why would this race condition happen? It happens because in Kubernetes, we use an ingress resource, but behind the scenes, it can be an Amazon ALB, it can be a GCP, it can be an Azure load balancer, it can be an Nginx. And each one of them takes a different amount of time and has different versions in order to deregister a workload. So some of them might have mistakes, bugs, some of them might take longer or slower. So we would want to delegate this responsibility to a pre-stop hook to make sure that it happens properly. So in order to cope with that, let me tell you about what is a lifecycle pre-stop hook. It is a command that you can run inside of your shutting down process. And it runs before SIG term is sent to the application. So it's a command that you can execute. It can be either whether an exec command or an HTTP signal that you send somewhere. Now the main difference between the two is that a SIG term is a signal that is sent to our process, while a pre-stop lifecycle hook is a command that is executed before sending the SIG term into our process. Therefore, what we can do in this case is implement a pre-stop hook that will go, start a deregistration process, verify that deregistration process has finished successfully, and only then proceed to sending a SIG term to our process, which will then gracefully finish draining and processing all of our requests and then terminate itself. And this way we can make sure that there are no connections coming into a terminated pod. So now that I've convinced you to use a pre-stop hook, let me help you by telling you about the four most common mistakes that people make when configuring a pre-stop hook. So number one is configuring an HTTP endpoint that handles the graceful shutdown and actually exposing it to the internet. The last thing you want to happen is some bot crawling your website and shutting down all of your servers. So make sure that if you use an HTTP endpoint, it is not exposed to the internet and only the internal networking can access it. The number two most common mistake that people do is to use an exec command and to just run sleep. Now this is bad because no matter how much sleep you configure, shutting down takes various amounts of time. Sometimes you have more load, you have less load, and it is just unreliable and unpredictable. So you should never use a sleep command. You should actually configure a command that checks your workloads and makes sure that, for example, you started the deregistration process with your ingress controller and you successfully finished it, and only then handling the SIG term process. The number three most common mistake is that people forget to change the default setting for termination graceful period seconds. Now this property defines what is the timeout that Kubernetes has in order to perform the shutdown sequence. This includes the pre-stop hook and the SIG term together. So make sure to increase it to 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute, 5 minutes, as long as you need in order for the pre-stop hook to execute correctly and then for the SIG term to also be processed. And the number four mistake many people do is they actually take all of the logic in the pre-stop hook and they shove it inside of their application. Now let's say you have a web server. It has to do the best job at handling traffic and returning the results you want to your users. And maybe you want a single responsibility model where this web server should not have all the logic of how to talk to a load balancer and how to ship your logs and how to make sure that everything is actually shutting down properly. For that, we want to use a pre-stop hook and to run a command that is on a container level, on a pod level, and that is handles all of those cleaning up processes, and the web server will know how to gracefully finish processing all of the requests that it has. And the number one biggest mistake that people do is to not configure a pre-stop hook. So I encourage you to do so. And in order to do it, we've actually introduced the tree policy rule that will verify that your workload has a pre-stop hook. So be sure to go and check it out. Thank you very much.